child walks into a classroom, it should be a place of high expectations and high performance.
Not quite live from the gem of the Fox River Valley, Algonquin, Illinois, USA, it's Good Morning Eastview. Starring Sir Smokey the Dog.
Cool.
Featuring the research base full of rigor news team. And now, ready, steady, go! It's Good Morning Eastview.
Good morning, Eastview. I'm Carlo, and welcome back to Eastview's number 3 information gathering device.
And I'm Audrey, and with us today, as always, is the puppy franchise here at the big barn we like to call Eastview, Sir Smokey the Dog.
Hello, Googlers. What is the good word?
Smokey.
Is it Smokey? Is that the good word? Smokey?
This is the story of the famous Billygoat curse in Chicago.
What's a curse? Are they real curses?
Some people think so,
but most likely it's just bad luck.
It's a good question, isn't it?
Many Chicago Cubs fans believe that a fan and an angry goat were involved with holding the Cubs back from finding success with baseball's most unenviable record of losses.
All because of a goat?
All because of a goat.
It was the 1945 World Series, and the Chicago Cubs were leading 2-1 against the Detroit Tigers. The Tigers went into Wrigley Field for Game 4.
In the park that day was an eccentric Cubs fan named William Billygoat Sianis.
He showed up to cheer on his Cubbies with 2 box seat tickets. One for himself and another for his pet goat named Murphy.
Many years before, Mr. Sianis had adopted a pet goat after it fell off a passing truck and wandered into his bar. Sianis grew a goatee and changed the name of the bar to the Billygoat Tavern.
Soon, everyone began to call him Billygoat. As we said before, in 1945, William Billygoat Sianis and his Billygoat Murphy were all decked out for the occasion. They entered Wrigley Field to cheer on the Cubbies.
Everything was okay until people in the seats caught a whiff of some mighty bad billy goat smell and complained to Cubs owner P.K. Wrigley, the chewing gum guy. He stepped in and told them that they weren't allowed in Wrigley Field because his goat smelled.
So Sianis went back to his Billygoat Tavern and put his curse on the Chicago Cubs. He said that the Cubs would not win any pennant or World Series from then on.
When the Cubs lost the pennant, Sianis sent a telegram to Mr. Wrigley saying, "Curse smells now."
Mr. Sianis' curse still seems to apply today, as the Cubs still have not made it to a World Series since the curse was cast in 1945. Every time they got close to a winning season, something freakish seems to knock them out.
In 1969, the Cubs are swept by the Miracle Mets after a black cat crosses the field.
1984, legendary Cub Leon Bull Durham flubs a routine grounder, and the Cubs hand San Diego the pennant.
In 2003, the Chicago Cubs are 5 outs away from the World Series when a fan unknowingly blocks a play and the Cubs are out of the running.
The Billygoat strikes again.
A curse, of course, isn't real.
Is it?
It was the night before Christmas. He lived all alone.
And I thought, yeah, I know who would like that. Me. So I ate it.
Oh. Harrison died after 31 days. Tyler, his vice, gave the Whigs a malaise. The Pacific is reached. Polk's expansion was steady. Then Taylor was nicknamed as Old Rough and Ready.
Oh. I feel much better admitting that now.
But I must taste the true reason why I come time and again to your village. Mem's pudding. Mem's pudding.
Take it from Squanto. Mem's pudding. So good, it'll knock you off your feet.
In the face of disappointment, in the face of setbacks and barriers, the strength to take one step, and then another, and then another.
The very thought put a tear to my eye. I dropped to my knees. I started to cry. The soldier awakened. I heard his rough voice. Santa, don't cry. This life is my choice. I fight for freedom. I don't ask for more. My life is my God, my country, my core. The soldier rolled over.
It makes me glad I made the drive. From his window, he waves goodbye.
So many things seem to stay the same forever, but so many change. It was time to move on, but this time I knew that I would miss it. We all did. I look forward to my future. However, for me, my past makes me smile in a sad kind of way. It's my blue side. Good morning, Eastview, this week. I'm Audrey.
Have a great day, Eastview. I'm Sir Smokey the Dog.
And I'm Carlo. If you think there's a curse on the Chicago Cubs due to a Billy Goat, then it is most likely that potatoes have ears as well.
Always the last to know.
Go ahead, Smokey. Say what you wanted to say.
Thank you for letting me be on Good Morning Eastview for the past 12 years. I'm Smokey the Dog. I'm gonna cry.